All right, folks. This morning, we're on our way to church. And I have to ask God to give me a special blessing this morning so that I can move forward and put some stuff behind me. Now, if we're going to be doing a vlog, we're going to be real in our vlog, right? So, let me say something. About 7 years ago, yeah, I said seven, a friend of mine told me some disturbing information. And let me just tell you where it stemmed from. I had gotten a divorce from my oldest daughter, Mia's dad. And my friend said, "Hey, I ran into one of your cousins," and this is in Chattanooga, Tennessee, because I graduated in Chattanooga. "I ran into one of your cousins, and she told me some disturbing information." He said, "I couldn't do anything but laugh." And the reason why he said he couldn't do anything but laugh, because he and I have been communicating for years, since high school. And pretty much one of the only people I had really been communicating with, because we were such great friends growing up. I've known him since I was 12 years old. And he said, "Well, yeah," he said, "I asked her, has she talked to you?" And she said, "Oh, no, I haven't talked to her, but she down there in Florida. She going through a divorce. Her husband beat her up and gave her a black eye. And she living in a hotel." And I was like, "What?" So he said, he just laughed, because the only thing that was true in that statement was that I was going through a divorce. My ex-husband never, and I say never, ever put his hands on me. I would never tell that lie about my first husband. I would never tell that lie to anybody or let anybody tell that lie. And he said, "Well, I knew it was funny." I said, "So why you didn't, you should have just straightened that. You should have just told her, you know, hey, that's not what the story is." Because, you know, first off, you don't want somebody lying and spreading rumors about somebody that's not true, you know. And I said, "Black eye? Where did I get a black eye from?" And what it is, my her daughter had come to visit with my dad. And her daughter, you know, was young, a little girl, like what, maybe 10, probably 9 or 10 years old. And she had never been in such, you know, the apartments were very nice and elaborate. So when she came there, she was like, "Oh, is this a hotel? It's so beautiful." I said, "Oh, no, baby, this is an apartment complex, you know," because I had left the house and moved into an apartment. So that's where that stemmed from. The little girl, you know, went home and told her mom, I guess, that it was, you know, such a big place. She, you know, she wasn't used to seeing something like that, because where they live, you know, and I'm sorry, but they were living in the hood. So she had never had the opportunity to be in such a nice place. And okay, but my thing is, before you start running off at the mouth, get your facts straight, you know. First off, I hadn't seen this relative of mine. I hadn't seen her at that point in, like, I want to say maybe 10 years, maybe 10 or 11 years. Haven't talked to her, didn't know her phone number, nothing. I knew where she lived through other relatives, but that's all I knew. But my thing is, if you don't know something about somebody, don't try to act like you know something about somebody. And never, you should, no one should ever make statements or bear false witness to something or someone or someone's situation. If you don't know, say you don't know. "Oh, I don't know. I heard she was getting a divorce," and that's it. You know, and you're taking, you know, a child's words, where all you had to do was ask my dad. All you had to do was say, you know, "Hey, Uncle Eric, Uncle Jerome, you know, blah, 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 blah." But no, instead, you want to run off at the mouth. So I let that go. Never said anything. Never picked up a phone and called and blessed anybody out or said anything, said a word. I tried to let it, you know, I tried to brush it off my shoulder. And, you know, because, I mean, that was the best thing to do. Turn the other cheek, per se. But recently, I joined the Facebook family. Yay, Facebook. Go Facebook. And, you know, I told my daughter, I said, "I don't care about Facebook. I, you know, that's not something I'm interested in, blah, blah, blah." But everybody, every time I turned around, someone was asking me, you got Facebook? And I'm like, no. I said, one more person asked me about some dog on Facebook. I'm just going to have to do a page. So my daughter was like, come on, mama, I'll help you. And it was like, I'll help you. And I said, okay. So she helped me set up my little page or whatever. And it was just so cute. And it was cute. See Nia over there on the truck. Yes, it was cute, and the response was just wonderful. I mean, what is it? In 2 days? Not even 2 days. What has it been, like 20? Yeah, it's been about two days. Yeah, I have 93 people either answered or sent me a request. So it made me kind of emotional because I was able to see some cousins, some family members that I haven't seen in years, haven't talked to, some family members that I've never met. I found out, was able to catch up on some things and, saw a lot of friends, people I grew up with, people I went to high school with,
that's true.
People who helped, kind of changed me or influenced my life in some sort of way. So it was very emotional for me because, when you reminisce, it's sometimes it can be really good. And then one of my cousins messed me up. Oh my God, LeBron Hunter, I love you. He posted a picture of my grandmother. Oh my God. And she's deceased. God bless her soul. Most wonderful woman in the world. So when I saw that, I just lost it. But anyway, Facebook can be a good thing and Facebook can be a bad thing, but to me, it's all in what the material you put on it, the things that you say and do, the things that you do to people or whatever. My experience has been great because, it's only been on it for 2 days, but it's been great because I've had so many inspirational things. People have been calling me, it's just been phenomenal. But I had another friend of mine. I haven't talked to this person. It's been what, 19, maybe 19 or 20 years? And this person called me and said, hey girl, where you been? Blah, 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 I miss you. You was my ace boom coon. Blah, blah, blah. Brought back a lot of good memories. And then that person said, hey, I saw your cousin the other day. Now this is the sister of the one who made the bad mistake of lying on me the first time. And statements were made, oh, she's so bougie, oh, she too good to talk to us, oh, she doing this and she down there with somebody who doing it. I'm like, Lord, here we go again. So I said to him, he asked her, well, do you have her number? Her address? I want to write a letter. No, I don't know nothing about it. I don't know. Okay, so I said to him, she said she don't know my number, right? He said, no. She don't know my address, right? No. She don't even know what city I'm living in. She know I live in Florida, but she don't even know what city. Nope. She don't even know my husband's name. Nope. She don't even know my new daughter, my little one, the 6-year-old. She don't even know her name, right? Nope. Okay. She don't know if I'm working. She don't know what I'm doing, right? No. Okay, so how she know what's going on in my life? If I don't talk to her, haven't talked to her, haven't seen her, how does she know what's going on in my life? Because everything she's telling you, she don't know what she's talking about. So then he said, oh, I know your character, Conchita. I know, if anything, he said, I knew instantly that person was lying. First off, he said, that person has always been jealous of you, even when we were kids. He threw out some instances and to me, sometimes you never know how observant other people can be about other people. And he just started saying stuff to me and, bringing up stuff about when we were kids and when we were younger, and I had never thought about some of the things he had been saying. I never knew that other people were seeing some of, how sometimes you'd be like, is it just me? Oh, it's this. So it was so refreshing to be able to talk to somebody who knew and knows the real me, who knows some of the struggles I went through, even with family members, hating, You know? Sad. Real sad. But on this day, I'm at my church, and I'm going to give it to God, honey, this morning. I'm going to give it to God. I'm going to say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lord! Thank you, Lord. I'm going to say, thank you, Lord, you know, for giving me peace of mind. And I'm just going to cast my cares upon the water. And that, too, will be taken care of. But the moral of the day, folks, the moral of the story of the day, Don't be that person. Don't be that person that spreads strife and negativity and lies and, you know, just you don't know what's going on in somebody's life, but you decide because your life is so miserable that you have to say something. Because, see, at the end of the day, you know, I could have threw some stones of my own, but okay, you see me backing up, lady? Go up pulling the sheet. She ain't even look. He didn't even look. He just backing out. But anyway. Yeah, I could have threw some stones of my own. Like, oh, your husband used to sell drugs. Excuse me. Oh, your husband used to beat on you. Oh, sorry. Okay, I'm going to cut. I'm digressing. Sorry, guys. But anyway, moral of the story. Don't spread untruths. If you don't know the truth, if you don't know who it is, go ahead, y'all. You don't know the truth, you don't know what's going on, don't talk about people. And don't put stuff in your mouth if you don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
Because I'm an open person. You want to know something about me? Ask me. I'll choose if I tell you the answer or not. But at the end of the day, it'll be the truth when I do answer.
Yeah.
All right, folks. Love, peace, and hair grease. We are going to church. Love you guys.
Guess what?
All right, folks. I wanted to show y'all my church. This is my church. Can y'all see that? Let me just brand it all the way down. All the way down. And it goes all the way down. And it goes all the way down there. I don't have a scrunchie on me. But yep, we are at church this morning. That's those people over there. My family. My daughters. My granddaughter. Yeah, we're late. Come on, because you're slow. What's up, guys? All right. I'm getting ready to go in. Going in on some... Domino's. Yes, I said Domino's. Have you guys tried their pasta primavera? Ooh, we'll slap yourself. Let me show it to you. Let me just show it. Let's open this puppy up here. I'm going to show you some goodness. I've already opened it a little bit, so. Look at that. Oh, my goodness. You got your pasta and your spinach and your mushroom and some tomatoes, some cheese. What? Now, see... this is the tin version. It's just the, you know, the pasta primavera in a tin. They also have it with the bowl. I don't do the bowl because I don't want a lot of bread. Even though it's good, you're supposed to dip it, whatever. I don't do all of that. I want the pasta. You hear my grandbaby in the back. She back there. She said, yeah, I want some too, but she can't have none. But just want to let you guys know it is off the chain. I just want to let you know, if you haven't tried it, run on over to your nearest Domino's or have them come to your house and bring it to you. Make sure you tip the drivers, please. Always tip service people because they need to eat too. Okay? Well, I'm just going to watch. That's some good eating. All right, y'all. I'm telling you. Some of the best pasta. Don't sleep on Domino's. Don't sleep. Hey, guys. It's me. Chi-chi. I am getting ready to go over the words with Kaylee. If you watch my other video, How to Teach a Child to Read in 1 Week, you'll see... she's ready. That's why she's doing that. You'll see how I taught both Nia, my 21-year-old. I started with her when she was, what, like 13, 14 months. And Lenora, my 6-year-old, I actually started with her when she was 9 months old on how to read words. So she was reading in pre-K on the first grade level. In first grade, she's reading on a second, third, almost a third grade level right now. So I'm going to show you the process a little bit of how I'm starting with Kaylee. Kaylee's not really talking a lot right now. She can only say mama, daddy, boo, boo. she can't tell you she had the boo, boo. She could just say, boo, boo, okay? what's the other word? Eat. She can say eat. I taught her that. So she can, when she's ready to eat food, she'll say eat. Okay. So I have five words. I always start with five. So I'm just going to do a little bit. And this is simple. She's not going to be able to tell me what they are right now because she's not really a talker yet. But I'm going to continue to do these. I do this five times a day, every day. Eventually, as you see us taping, she'll know these words. Okay? Here we go. Oh, hush. Look at that. What's this word? Milk. You'll see the word is milk. Okay. Our next word, Kaylee, is eyes. Eyes. Our next word is nose. Nose. Mouth. Ear. Ooh, excuse you. One more time. Milk. Okay. Eyes. Yeah, look at the word. Eyes. Nose. Nose. Mouth. Our last word, baby. Ear. All right, we're finished. Okay, all right, guys. And see, you can see she doesn't know the words right now, but she's engaged. She's looking at them. She's listening to me. But, of course, she's not saying them yet because she's not able to put the words together yet. But as we continue with our vlogs, you're going to see eventually this girl's going to be reading every card I show her. And I'm going to add more and more and more and more as we go forward. But, all right, I just wanted to say and show you guys how we're starting to teach her how to read. All right, guys. Check you later.